Light always travels in a straight line, and with lasers, that's very easy to see. But even with light bulbs, light is traveling in straight lines. It's just traveling out from the light bulb in every direction at once. Here we have a blue light bulb glowing inside a dark room, and that blue bulb is making everything around it look blue. But you'll also notice that there is a hole in the paper that's in front of the blue bulb, and one dot of blue light that's behind that paper. So this provides evidence that light is traveling in straight lines. Even though light is coming out of that blue bulb in every direction, only the light that's traveling in a straight line towards the hole makes it through the hole and onto the paper in the background. And that's where we get that one dot of blue light. And so you can clearly see that light has traveled in a straight line through that hole to create this dot of light. Reflection occurs when light strikes an object and bounces off. And so here you can see light rays reflecting off these surfaces. So here we have a toy tree in front of a white square and in front of a mirror. Now light is reflecting off both surfaces. So why does an image only form on the mirror? Rough surfaces scatter light in different directions. This is why you cannot see an image on rough surfaces. But images can be seen on smooth surfaces. This is because the light is all reflected in the same direction. Light reflects off mirrors and other smooth surfaces in a very predictable way, and you can see that here. The law of reflection describes how light reflects off mirrors and smooth surfaces in a symmetrical way. And you can see that here in this picture. The laser beam is reflecting off this mirror in a symmetrical way. Now, light can be reflected by an object, or light can be absorbed by an object. On the left, you see light being reflected. It's bouncing off that surface. But on the right, you see that instead of the light bouncing off the surface or even going through the object, that light energy is actually being absorbed by the object. And the amount of light that's reflected or absorbed by an object actually determines its color. The color white reflects the most light, and the color black absorbs the most light. On the left, you can clearly see all six Legos in the normal light. But when I turn the lights out, it's much easier to see the Legos made from white plastic. That's because they're reflecting the light that's in the room. Even though there's only a little light, they're reflecting that, so I can still see the white Legos pretty easily. But the Legos made from black plastic are absorbing more light than they reflect, so they become much harder to see in the low light. When light travels from one medium to another, it bends. And this bending of light is called refraction. In our picture on the left, you can see a laser going from one medium to another. The laser is going from air, that's the first medium, into water, that's the second medium. And when that happens, it bends, and you can clearly see that as the light goes from the air to the water, it's bending. That is called refraction. And in our second example, you can see that we have a prism made of glass. And so as the light goes from the air into the glass, it bends. And as it goes from the glass back into the air, it bends again. Whenever light travels from one medium to another, it bends. And we call that refraction. Refraction causes items to look bent or broken when they're placed in water. And you can see here that in each of these examples, the item looks bent or broken. That's because as the light travels from the water into the air, it bends, and that distorts the image that you see and makes everything look bent or broken. Lenses are designed to refract light in a useful way. And you can see here that the shape of the lens determines how the light refracts through it. But whenever you see a lens, you should know that it is refracting light. That's what lenses are for. Lenses are for refraction. Prisms also refract light. The different colors bend different amounts as they travel from one medium to another. So if I shine white light through a prism, I'll get a rainbow on the other side. White light looks white because it actually contains all of the colors. And you can see on the right very clearly that as that beam of white light goes through the prism, it spreads apart, and on the other side, I can see all the colors that have been refracted different amounts. So prisms refract light and allow us to see a rainbow. And the rainbows that you see outside are formed as light refracts as it travels between air and droplets of water. So when light travels from one medium to another, it refracts. And the different colors bend different amounts, and that's why you end up seeing all the different colors. When an object is magnified, it looks bigger. Both lenses and mirrors can be used to magnify an object. So if you see a lens, you should know that lenses refract light. So if a lens is magnifying an object, then that is happening through refraction. But if you see a mirror magnifying an object, then that must be happening through reflection. And that happens when the mirror is curved instead of flat. But if you see mirrors, you know that mirrors reflect light. So lenses and mirrors can cause things to look larger. They can magnify an image. But lenses always work by refracting light, and mirrors reflect light. I hope this video has helped you understand light a little bit better. Keep up the great work, and I'll see you next time.